The Philippine Red Cross has launched its saliva testing for COVID-19 after securing approval from the Philippine Health Department. Aside from a shorter processing time of 3 to 4 hours, it is also cheaper at 2,000 pesos compared to swab tests that can go as high as 5,000. Joining us this morning is Senator Richard Gordon. Senator, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen.
All right, how was the first day of the rollout?
Oh, we tested the media for free so that they're glad to feel good about it. I think we tested over 6,000 yesterday, and I believe some of that were part of the saliva test, and we're going to have more, I guess, as we go along.
Okay. Yeah. So yesterday you were able to test 6,000 just coming from one spot, from one site.
Right, but they were a combination of the swab test as well as the saliva test.
Okay,
so we were able to test 136 saliva, and I still haven't gotten the report how many were tested positive.
All right, once this goes on full rollout, Senator, clearly the DOH has given the permit, so to speak, for the Red Cross to do it. Are you going to roll this out nationwide in the first few days? How is the...
Definitely.
What is the SOP?
Our goal is to go nationwide by February 1. Today, we're open with our machines in Metro Manila and in Mandaluyong. So the two major laboratories of the country where we have about almost 20 machines in Manila are there. The rest of the country would have another 28 machines, which are capable of 1,000 tests a day. Mm-hmm. Now, all you have to do if you want to go to the lab is make a reservation at 1158 or book yourself at what we call book that Red Cross 1158. I'll give it to you later so you can flash it. And then it's so easy when they go there or when we go to the factories or when we go to the schools, if the schools are going to use it, we just give them a tube like this, and then you spit on the sieve, and then you put you lock it up, and then you put in the barcode. Of course, you have to fill up your CIF or client information form, and it's important that you fill it up well. And then it goes to the machine, it goes to the process, and within 3 hours, we can get your results. Of course, depending on how many are going to come. Ilan ang dadagsang magpapatest, no? But this is really going to be fast. It is non-invasive. Hindi ka natutusok sa ilong, hindi nakikirot yung ilong mo, hindi ka na natatakot. You can do it in your home, provided meron nagbabantay na talagang tama yung ginawa mo, and in the factory or in the schools, and then we can pick it up and then give you the results right away by way of computer, by way of internet, and you're in good shape.
So if you intend to have yourself tested, you need to first book online. You cannot walk in the Philippine Red Cross, or you can?
You can. But initially, it's better that you go line up so you don't have to wait a long time. But this is so fast anyway. You can easily... The beauty about it is you don't have to... No PPEs, so tipid na tayo doon. Wala ka nang babayaran magsaswab. Mm-mm. So mura, no? And then what is also important, hindi masakit, no? At saka right away, you get the results at... you can now use it for ease of sample collection. You can test 100 people in a room right away. Or in a factory. You can be maganda rito, you can use it for disease surveillance. I hope Dr. Vigeri is listening, and I'm sure she is aware of this. For disease surveillance, you can do it. The one thing I want to emphasize to our viewers and listeners is that you cannot do away with testing. Kahit na meron ka ng vaccine, kailangan magte-test ka. Kailangan may protection ka pa ng face mask, kailangan may protection ka pa ng hugas ng kamay at saka distancing. Because even if you get the vaccine, you could be a carrier. The rule is, I am my brother's keeper, but I can also be my brother's killer. I'll repeat that, no? Dapat ang kung natin, pag-alagaan natin sarili natin para hindi tayo makakasakit ng ating mga mahal sa buhay at yung ating mga katabi, no? So, kailangan, ito ang maganda rito, malalaman natin na mas mabilis kung sino ang merong sakit at pwede na silang i-isolate at magagawa na natin ang kanilang tulong. Like, the formula is prevent it, detect it, isolate it, treat, and then reintegrate them to the community.
Okay. This is a game changer also as we reopen the economy and invite people to travel more. We know that in traveling, in traveling locally, the RT-PCR is quite expensive. So let's say someone wants to go to Boracay, you'd have to like set aside 4,000 per head. If you're a family of five, that's 20,000 which you could have spent for your stay and your food, etc. So ang tanong ko, Senator, will or should the saliva test be accepted as a result to be given instead of the RT-PCR, let's say when you're about to ride a plane? Because alam naman natin, sir, di ba, ang nare-require RT-PCR pag sumakay ng aeroplano.
Pinayagan na yan ng DOH, so payag na lahat yan.
Good.
Pati sa airport, payag na lahat yan. Pangalawa, may PCR yan, Karen. Hindi na wala yung PCR.
Mm-mm.
We cannot do it without the PCR. Otherwise, you'll have bad results. No?
Ba-o.
Walang magiging result. Hindi papayagan ng DOH yan sa kanang RITM. Pangatlo, like I said, this is just a start. So, pagka dumagsa yan, I can bring it down perhaps to 1.5, even lower than 1.5. And ang maganda nito, yung mga magbabar ngayon, nag-usap kami ni Justice Leonel kahapon, eh, dalawang taon na sila hindi nakakapag-bar. Bago mag-bar sa November, they can do the saliva test.
You're right.
Within the 14 days, and then they can take the bar. Mayroon rin yung mga magsasabit ng thesis. Yung mga uniform services natin, pwede lang i-take yan. Kayo dyan sa studio, you can take it anytime. You can do it twice a month, no, if you like.
Yeah.
And for the school children, they can now go to school. Because makikita natin kung sino ang may-ari may nagdadala ng sakit at maayos natin kagad.
Oo. That's a good one. Maybe so it should be called saliva PCR, no? How are you calling it? Saliva PCR. No?
Salamat, Karen. You really are a smart lady.
No, I
call it saliva PCR.
Because RT-PCR, and there's always this discussion, and you're right. It's just the method, but it is PCR. So technically, am I correct that when, technically, let's say El Nido, you require an RT-PCR there, they should accept a saliva PCR.
Right. And for that matter, if you go to Boracay, if you have not tested, you can put you in a place where you can be quarantined, and then we can ship right away by car or whatever to our main molecular laboratory in Pasig, which is about, it can easily be done in 2-3 hours, and then it can come back to you in 3 hours, then you're good to go if you did not get your test. But of course, sa Manila pa lang, chichikin ka na dyan. So before you leave, you have the saliva test, you're good to go.
Okay. And is it true that it is, the RT-PCR used to be the gold standard, but now I'm reading several articles during the testing that the this saliva PCR is 99.9% accurate. Is it more accurate than the RT-PCR?
It's almost equally accurate as the gold standard. PCR is still the gold standard. That's why we're not letting it go. But in our test, we had about 99 sa PCR. I want to go to the solid numbers para mas madali. 98% sa saliva.
Okay.
So we can easily see what's happening. And we got this from the University of Illinois, and we had to sign a non-disclosure agreement.
Uh-oh.
And we had a young lady there by the name of Ms. Renova. You should interview her one of these days.
Okay.
She's a fantastic lady.
Okay.
And I'll tell you, because of that, we were able to get this as fast as we can. They test regularly, they monitor, and we will be doing that in the Red Cross as well. They tested 1.1 million. Alam mo ang results ng kanilang test? 0.36% lang. Not even 1% ang positivity rate.
Okay, so it is the wave of the future, so to speak, no? The results come out 3 to 4 hours. Is that
right?
I'm curious, is it just because it's new, or really you believe that's the best turnaround time?
No, I think it's the minimum is 3 hours. Not that bad, no. Oh. But of course, when we are testing, they now after you test, you know, you will put your saliva test. Here's the saliva test. I made it bigger to make it easier.
Go ahead.
And you put it on a box like this.
Yeah. See? Can you put all it up? Holes. Put it up, Senator. Yeah, so we can see it. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. And which means that you test 96 of these, and then you bring it to the laboratory. We can pick it up, or you can deliver it yourself, provided your HR is authorized. You have a nurse there; we'll authorize her to make sure that you do it in front of her, so you do it properly, and the filling up of the form is there, and then you bring it to the lab, and then. Inactivation is also in bulk now. Hindi na isa-isa. Dati-dati, pupunta ka pa dun sa malaking makina namin, natatanggalin mo pa yan, tapos you have pipettes, iniisa-isa yun, yun nagtatagal.
Oo.
Mabilis ito.
Oo, kasi ito, in bulk, you just put it inside.
Right. And also, you forego the notch test, yung malaking makina, hindi na namin gagamitin yun. It goes directly to the PCR.
And is that a loss for many labs? I'm curious. Those who've invested in labs, will that be a big loss?
Not necessarily. I think they would have made their money by now. Mm. But what is important is that we get the job done, and all they have to do is apply with the RITM to get their process approved. If they want to do this saliva test, they're welcome to do that. No, certainly. There is really an argument to be made about having, these laboratories properly monitored. Now, if you have too many, mahirap mag-monitor.
Uh-oh.
The nice thing about the Red Cross is we have, in 13 areas, we have at least 2 machines each, no? Mm. Or some 4 machines each, mm-mm, capable of 1,000 per test. So that means marami tayong matetest and we can monitor where it comes from. And that is important.
Okay.
And what we're going to do tomorrow, for example, last night we were meeting with our chapter administrators, and we still continue to meet today in Manila. They can now have our chapters go in there, and they will have this, and the people can just spit on it, and then it will be brought to the molecular laboratory in Intramuros or in Mandaluyong. Then later on, Batangas will follow for Central Luzon, for Southern Luzon. We will have mobile saliva collection teams for companies.
Bo-o.
You know, for barangays. You'll schedule them and say, this is your turn today.
Oh.
So, dalhin niyo yung mga tao nyo. So, we will do the saliva test.
Oo. Okay. Magkakaroon kayo ng mobile saliva testing? You have the manpower for that?
Yeah, we have the vehicles. But that is why we need PhilHealth and DOH a little bit more cooperation. Mm. You know, we... This is one thing I wanna say something about, and I hope everybody's listening here. We have an application insofar as the case investigation form. It's one page, all right?
Uh-oh.
Well, when I got it back yesterday, when I was presenting it, I was not told that all of a sudden the epidemiology department included 4 more pages.
Yeah.
So it will defeat the speed of doing it. And the 4 more pages really mean tracing after you find them positive. And dito, you just have to find out who's positive and negative.
Yeah.
And if it's positive, then they can do the tracing. Unfortunately, they want us to do everything for them.
Mm.
They should do it. And you have to start talking to the people, because dito sa kanila may tinatanong pa ng mga technical terms. Halimbawa, tatanungin kita, kung ikaw mag-fill up nito, meron ka bang myalgia? Meron ka bang kurisa?
Yeah.
Meron ka bang dyspnea?
Yeah, what are those?
Even I don't understand that.
What are those? So this is the DOH form?
This is the epidemiology form of DOH. I don't think... I texted Secretary Duque. I'm sure he's going to do something about it. Also, Vince Dizon was complaining to them about it. It defeats the purpose. Dapat one page. Tapos ka agad, pag nag-positive, habulin natin. Hindi naman ganun karami ang makikita mong positive eh.
Oo.
Diba? If you get 200, you trace them, then you fill up the form, sino kasama mo, saan ka galing, which is also covered in our original test. Have you traveled lately? Where did you come from? Kasama na yan. Pero okay, ito, sinasama na lahat, pati sino pinantahan mo, sino kasama mo. That is a tracing system designed for somebody that got positive. Yeah. Ang trabaho ng Red Cross is to test lang right away so we know who's got it and then that is referred to DOH. That is where the tracing system you know, comes in.
Okay. Now, I know this is better for Dr. Mike T, but then you might know the answer to this too because you're exposed to the saliva test. He said in the interview yesterday that the saliva test can detect COVID-19 in an asymptomatic patient. So, for example, I'm curious, did you discuss it? Let's say someone is asymptomatic and I've had COVID for 3 days, but I'm asymptomatic. If I take the saliva test, if it's just 2 to 3 days I've had it, will the saliva test detect if I have COVID already?
Yes, you can. Mm. You have to be in the infectious period. Uh-oh. 7 days of infectious period.
Seven.
So we can detect. We can detect that. So that's why we're saying once every 2 weeks, right?
Uh-oh.
And the kids can have it. It depends if ang parents or may kaya. At pag bumaba na ito, you can test as once a week, you know.
Okay.
In the University of Illinois, they test once a week, yeah, and it's paid for by the university.
Yeah.
Now, the point here is when we test, we can detect that. And I'll emphasize one point. Even if you have a vaccination already, Karen,
yeah,
you still have to follow the mask, you still have to follow washing your hands, etc. It is like you are asymptomatic.
Uh-oh.
Like, I'm asymptomatic, I don't know I have it, but I have it, even if I had the vaccine, I have it. So, and I go to somebody, I can transfer it to somebody without knowing it.
Uh-uh.
And that's why this testing is so important. You cannot do away with testing. I will emphasize that a million times. Testing is the key. Knowing that your enemy is out there and discovering it, that is the key.
Okay.
Vaccine, even if you have the vaccine applied to you, that would only prevent you from having a very, very bad case of the infection, but you can still infect somebody with it. And, you know, some people are saying it will take 4 to 5 years before we are able to vaccinate the whole thing. So in the meantime, we must use this.
All right. Very quickly, Senator, is this covered by PhilHealth?
That is, it's already covered, should be, according to Vince, according to Secretary of Health, it must be covered. And I think they should be jumping with joy because instead of paying us more, they're paying us less.
Yeah.
You know, how many people will be honest with PhilHealth and say, okay, we'll charge you less.
Yeah.
And if we get a lot more, we'll even put it down so that the money of the government is expanded to more testing.
Because I think in the past, I mean, not many people knew, but the RT-PCR, I think PhilHealth could cover something like 750 per test. Were you aware of that, Senator? I'm not sure because of what this will cover since it's cheaper.
No, it will cover the whole amount.
Provided the whole amount?
Yeah, the whole amount. Like they pay us for 3,409. That is the price that they gave us, no?
Okay.
And actually, we've given it cheaper to others and we're willing to give it cheaper now, especially with this, we can lower the cost even of the swab test. But the saliva test is what I like to lower because it's fast. May confidence ang tao. Even the president, pinuri ko nga si Presidente kapon, sabi ko, kung di si Presidente, hindi bibilis. Dahil ang tagal-tagal lumakad at hindi ko naman tinitira yung HTA, yung Health Technology Assistance Office, no? Assessment Office. Nung sinabi ni Presidente, sabi ni Gordon, effective raw yung saliva test, eh ako, nasasaktan ako sa ilong, eh gamitin natin yan.
Okay.
So biglang bumilis,
Now, is it less effective? Because the guidelines state that you should not eat, drink, gargle, smoke, or vape 30 minutes before the test. You said that yesterday. I'm curious.
That's correct.
Will it have will the results be less accurate if you do? Let's say if somebody ate a candy or a chocolate bar. I mean, I don't know.
No, we will not let you test if you have eaten and we will double-check that. Sayang ang pera.
Like when you say drink, do you mean drink water? So no water 30 minutes before?
Well, wala pa kami sinabihan na drink. I would, you know, half an hour not drinking water is good enough. I don't know if I cannot tell you because I'm not a technologist. Yeah. No? But I can say, do not eat.
Do not eat.
Do not brush your teeth. Do not use mouthwash.
Even brush your teeth. Okay.
Do not smoke tobacco products. 30 minutes lang naman eh.
Yeah. No, I'm just curious.
Yeah.
That's why. I mean, is it proven to be less effective if one does?
I think it will tarnish the test. Let's just follow the rules.
I see. It may tarnish the test.
Half an hour lang eh, di ba?
All right. Okay. Anything else you'd like to add about the saliva testing, sir, before we go to a quick break and move to other issues?
I just want, that is confirmed from my doctors in BRC. Do not drink water or any liquid.
Pati water.
Any liquid.
But so technically fasting. That's the best. You need to fast for 30 minutes.
Yes. No, just don't eat. Just don't eat half an hour before. By the way, I'd like to correct myself.
Water. Okay, go ahead.
We still use the Natch machine, the big one, because of the pipette reagents that we have to put in the batch.
Okay.
There's a pipette like a something like a long pen that sticks to every one of the samples, so that but it's a lot faster now.
So two things that are important. You said in Metro Manila, the saliva test is available in Mandaluyong and Makati, correct?
No. Mandaluyong and Metro Manila. Let's put it this way. It's available everywhere. If you want, you try us. You send some people to send us a batch of these tubes, and it will come with the kit, the tube, and then
Ayun.
What we want you to do is before we go in there is you fill up the one page form, and once you have the one page form, then we go there after all the tubes are collected, then we bring it to the lab. Okay. Or you can bring it to the lab.
Can we put the graphics back direct of the other one, because we showed there were I think 42,000 labs of Red Cross. This is all over the Philippines. And are you saying, Senator, as of today, that's all available already?
Yes, in fact, we're under capacity.
18,000 labs. Okay, 18,000.
We have a lot of capacity, and we're only testing, dito sa swab, we're only testing an average of 8,000 to 10,000 a day. And yet, you have the capacity for I'd like to correct that. I think we have 48,000.
No, 13 labs, 18,000 tests in Metro Manila, 42,000 tests nationwide.
Yeah, that's
so,
correct.
But
that's
the, correct. All the 18 labs, Senator, as of today, can take saliva tests already.
By February 1. We're rolling it out. Tomorrow it will probably be in Laguna. In Batangas, no? And then in Central Luzon.
Mm-mm.
And then that's why we'd like to see how it works out in Manila. But, you know, we can't wait. You know, with all these variants coming out, we have to make sure that our people are protected.
Uh-oh. So in Metro Manila, where can they go? Mandaluyong and where?
Mandaluyong and Port Area. The big building of the Red Cross is there, where our dialysis center is as well.
Okay, because I think it's important to know in Metro Manila, because the fact that you can walk in makes a whole difference, no? And
yes.
For people that travel, usually now kasi the resort you go to has a tie-up with a lab. A private lab. But if you're saying ideally they should accept saliva PCR already, then they can go to Red Cross and it has to be accepted.
They have to accept it because this is the standard that the DOH has sent apart from the swab test. And what is important is they get tested. Now, early days pa tayo, so a lot of people can get tested easily when they walk in. I will tell our labs in Manila, papasukin nyo, just make sure that there's distancing.
Yeah.
We have a big room there. They can have 100 people that can go inside, or especially bigger in Mandaluyong. And you can test as fast as we can.
Okay. My last question before the break, I'm curious, how much does PhilHealth still owe you? Because what's interesting, you're now changing tests. And yeah. wouldn't you want to close that billing first before you move to this?
Look at my hands.
Yeah, yeah.
I've been trying to get them to pay the whole amount. So para sa ganun, we are not...
Para you start clean.
Right. And right now, they owe us 604,437,048 pesos. No? They paid us yesterday, I believe, 46,000. And then we billed them 48,000. So
you mean million? They paid you 46 million.
A million.
Okay. So far, more than 600 million na lang ang utang ng PhilHealth. Ideally, before you go
No,
kasi coming from close to a billion. Before you move into a saliva test, ideally, you should close this billing.
They must.
Ideally, yeah. Yeah, because you'll be using, whole different supplies for
by
your
the way,
next batch.
Yes, we had to buy a lot of other things like water bath and the bottles, the vials.
Yeah,
we have the circulating water bath, the water bath drain kit, the stainless steel racks, heat resistant gloves. And by the way, I am now considering buying new machines in the U.S. which can handle. At a time, not 96, but 384 at a time.
Tests.
Yeah. So your machine now is able to do the work of four machines in one machine.
Wow. All right.
That's why PhilHealth has to pay us.
PhilHealth has to pay you. Okay. All right. So, are you taking another tack for them to pay you? Is there any other method?
Actually, it's not funny, and I'm really serious about this, and I'm just biting my lip, and I don't want to be looking at as a looked at as a we're
yes,
trying to get
absolutely
people. We don't.
Yeah,
we're doing this for our country. Imagine, kung hindi kami nag-test, ang testing ng Red Cross ngayon nasa 1,771,275 tests.
Okay,
that's almost 25% of the entire country. The next one is 533,000. And in Metro Manila, we're 37%. If we stop testing, we're all in trouble. The whole object of this exercise is to recover our economy. Ibalik natin yung mga tao sa fabricas, sa mga BPOs, makapagtrabaho ng maayos.
Mm-mm.
Pangalawa, ibalik natin ang mga eskwela, makapag-aral ang mga bata, hindi natatagal na nahihirapan sila at yung mga kailangan mag-test, makatest, at pati mga drivers makakuha ng test para lalakad na talaga ang ating ekonomiya. That is the whole object.
Okay.
Kaya pinilisan natin to.
Oo. Senator, if you can answer this in 1 minute, I wanted to ask you, but we don't have enough time. I know that there's a Senate hearing on Wednesday regarding charter change. Would you say you are for it with the economic provisions? What are your main issues on it?
Another time, another place.
Okay, another time, another place. Not now, meaning
focus.
Okay. All right. Another thing is Senator Lacson is calling after the erroneous red tagging that the UP-DND accord should be now returned. I don't know if you've studied this for now because you've been busy.
Yes.
What's your opinion on it, sir?
Well, Senator Lorenzana is a good man, no? And I trust him, no? General Lorenzana. Pero ang gusto ko lang sabihin is, not the time, you know. Una, the armed forces protects our country. The police can go in anywhere. Kaya lang, may special consideration sa academic freedom. Nakakatakot na mga bata, nagdi-discussion dun sa pavilion, tapos biglang sabihin nila, mga komunista sila o huliin sila. I think that's wrong. I don't think we should do that. I think we should allow some slack. And we don't need an agreement like this. It's just respecting each other's objectives for our country.
All right. On that note, Senator Richard Gordon, thank you so much and hope to have you again on Head Start, sir. Thank you.
Glad to be here, Karen. Thank you very much.
All right.